Einen wunderschönen guten Abend und willkommen bei den Alrix. Ich habe eine Kerze angezündet, ihr wisst, was das bedeutet. Cthulhu Horror Nacht. Eigentlich ist es jetzt das erste Mal zugegeben, aber ich etabliere das jetzt einfach mal so. Wir spielen ein weiteres Solo-Abenteuer aus dem Cthulhu-Universum und heute ein ganz spezielles noch dazu: Alone Against the Flames. Das Besondere ist, dass wir es auf Englisch spielen werden, weil es auf Deutsch ganz einfach nicht verfügbar ist. Es wurde bislang einfach noch nicht ins Deutsche übersetzt. Vielleicht können wir hoffen, vielleicht kommt es mal. Ist bis jetzt aber leider nicht der Fall. Es ist ein Solo-Abenteuer, das zu den Schnellstartregeln gehört und bei dem man während dem Spielen auch immer wieder Anweisungen bekommt, wie man seinen ersten Investigator erstellt. Ich habe das jetzt schon vor dem Spiel erledigt, mehr dazu gleich. Das PDF ist gratis auf chaosium.com erhältlich. Ihr könnt es euch dort runterladen und ich habe es euch natürlich auch unter dieses Video gepackt. Gleiches mit den Schnellstartregeln. Die bekommt ihr über den Pegasus PDF Shop. Die gibt es auf Deutsch, das ist überhaupt kein Problem und auch die findet ihr unter dem Video. Diese wunderschöne alte Petroleumlampe funktioniert noch. Ich habe mir heute auch extra Petroleum gekauft und die mal aufgefüllt, um zu sehen, wie das läuft, aber die hat einen Leck. Und wenn ich die jetzt auch noch anzünde, dann kämpfe ich hier im Studio allein gegen die Flammen und ihr werdet dann in Zukunft sehr, sehr viele Videos zu sehen bekommen, wo es darum geht, wie man ein neues Haus kauft. So, jetzt aber zurück zum Investigator. Ich habe mir überlegt, dass wir das Abenteuer mit demselben Charakter spielen, den wir in Allein gegen die Dunkelheit hatten. Professor Louis Grunewald, der stammt ja aus Arkham, saß 7 Jahre lang in einem ägyptischen Gefängnis und kommt jetzt zurück nach Arkham. Besitz hat er dort keinen mehr, Arbeit auch keine mehr, ist alles den Bach runtergegangen. Aber ja, ich würde diesen Ansatz gerne versuchen, um einfach eine Brücke zum vorigen Cthulhu-Solo-Abenteuer herzustellen. Wir werden heute also wieder in Arkham ankommen. In unserer Professorenkluft, ihr erinnert euch, brauner Fedora, Umhängetasche, Revolver, naturfarbenes Leinenhemd und Lederjacke. Wir müssen so um die 60 sein mittlerweile. Ich bin gespannt, wie das funktioniert und wie es läuft. Ja, dann bleibt mir nur noch zu raten, was der Einstiegstext des Abenteuers mir geraten hat. Just settle in a comfortable chair before a roaring fire. On second thoughts, don't sit too close to the fire. The sun is high in the sky, a merciless ball of heat. You feel scorched by the time you reach the pass hold in front of Osborne's drugstore. It's a relief to put down your heavy cases and take off your hat for a moment. You fan your face. It has been a long summer here in your hometown, and yet a curiously empty one. You look across the street at the grubby butcher's shop, the grocer's with its faded awning, and the shabby tobacconist. Mistrustful faces glare at you as they pass, eyeing your clothes and luggage. It was your parents' choice to live here, not yours. You were happy down south as a child, among Providence's white-walled houses and leafy churchyards. Perhaps this new job in Arkham will supply the change you need. Yet everybody you know in the world lives here. You know nobody in Arkham, not one soul. You ask yourself one last time if you're doing the right thing. The answer is here. None of your supposed friends have come to see you off. You are alone. Whatever challenges lie in Arkham, it will be a new life and a brave one. A small gray motor coach approaches and rattles to a stop. You put your hat back and pick up your cases. Weiter bei 263. Two young men with sullen expressions alight from the coach. One looks you up and down before heading away. The driver also steps down, glancing at you before crossing the road to visit the tobacconist. When he returns, he is rolling a cigarette between his yellowed fingers. He gives it a final twist and examines you as he reaches for his matchbox. He's a thin man in his 50s, dressed in a stained shirt with the bus company emblem. Yet his eyes are sharp in their dark sockets.
Where to?
You show him your ticket for Ossipee. From there you will connect to Rochester and Portsmouth, before the Kestrel line to Newburyport and finally Arkham. You should be able to afford a rail ticket for at least some of the way, otherwise this will be the first of many long bus trips. The driver scratches the match and lights his cigarette. The end flares as he takes a draw. Then he exhales and gestures to the back of the coach.
Luggage racks up there.
The driver smokes and watches as you drag your cases to the back of the motor coach. The rack is set inconveniently high on the vehicle. You get a grip on the heavier case. If your size is 40, go to 23. If your size is higher than this, go to 38. Unsere Größe ist 45, also knapp höher. Können wir zu 38 gehen? The driver continues to enjoy his cigarette, watching with keen interest as you struggle with the cases. You grit your teeth and heave the second one into place. Perhaps the residents of Arkham will have better manners. Das wollen wir mal hoffen. 233. The driver flicks his cigarette into the gutter and steps into the motor coach. Its engine coughs into life. You board, grateful that you will be the only passenger for the initial part of your trip, at least. With mixed emotions, you watch from the window as the tired avenues of your bold home slip behind you, receding into the distance. For a few minutes, you can still see the church spire over the brow of a low hill. Then the road dips and it, too, is gone. Arkham is your new home. You will travel there and make a new start. The coach putters through the countryside. At first, the interior is stifling and your stomach lurches with every bend in the road. However, the driver opens his window and by switching seats you find a spot where the breeze hits your face. You soon relax into the journey, observing the quaint little hamlets that the coach serves. A heavy-set woman boards at one settlement and gives you a polite nod. She gets off the next one. The road rises a little, passing cornfields and orchards. The leaves are turning and the trees are alive with glorious reds and golds. You have just begun to doze when the driver takes a tight bend at speed. Wir müssen jetzt eine Geschicklichkeitsprobe würfeln. Was haben wir denn da? Wir haben Geschicklichkeit 60. Das sollte kein Problem sein, hoffe ich mal. 45. Ja, überhaupt kein Problem. If you pass the dexterity roll, go to 261. 261 ist unser Abschnitt. A desperate yell awakens you. You feel yourself slide from the seat as the driver spins the wheel and the motor coach plunges off the road. You grab hold of the seat in front, just in time to prevent a painful fall. The coach stops with a thump. Now you see what has happened. A Fordson tractor has stopped in the road and your driver has had to swerve to avoid his steel obstacle. He leaps from his seat into the road, unleashing a string of curses at the farmer. You take a moment to catch your breath. Perhaps you should offer assistance, but the driver has already returned. He backs the coach up a little and threads it around the tractor, glaring at the farmer. Weiter bei 71. Also nichts passiert, wir konnten hier nichts auswählen. You resume your journey. The driver takes the curves with more caution than before. He glances over his shoulder at you a couple of times.
Sorry about before, he says. That fella was dumber than a hawk. I'm Silas. What's your name?
The accident was at least as much Silas' fault as the farmer's. But it doesn't seem shrewd to antagonize a man while he is driving you through the middle of nowhere. Make up a name for your character. Okay, jetzt werden wir durchgeführt, einen Namen für unseren Charakter zu entwerfen. Haben wir schon gemacht. Wir sind Professor Louis Grunewald. Das Alter sollte zwischen 23 und 36 liegen. Ja, wir sind fast doppelt so alt, das kriegen wir nicht mehr ganz hin. Aber egal. The coach turns onto a narrow road which weaves uphill through woodland. Silas becomes chatty.
Going to Arkham, eh? Can't say I ever heard of the place. Went to Boston once. Didn't like it. Too much hustle and bustle. You got family there? A special someone waiting?
The afternoon is wearing on. You see no harm in confiding in Silas about your new life.
A job, eh? What's your line?
Choose from the following options. Okay, wir können sagen, if you're an antiquarian, if you're a doctor of medicine, if you're a journalist, if you're a private investigator, if you're a professor, hier ist es, 265. Wenn wir ein Professor sind, dann 265, wunderbar. You explain you're joining the facility at the renewed Miskatonic University. It's only a junior position with teaching and tutoring duties, but the institution is well regarded. Okay, macht irgendwie Sinn, wenn wir nach 7 Jahren zurückkommen, bekommen wir nur noch eine junior position. Who knows where the appointment might lead? A symposium, a visiting lectureship, even one of its world-spanning expeditions.
Silas wrinkles his nose. I had enough of book learning when I was young. Still, I suppose it's well enough for those who likes it.
Okay, jetzt wird uns gesagt, wie hoch unsere Finanzkraft ist. Nicht sehr hoch, aber das passt ja jetzt auch auf unseren Spezialfall. Und dann müssen wir... okay, also... das auszuwählen diente jetzt hier in dem Abenteuer dazu, um uns unsere Fertigkeiten zu geben. Man bekommt hier vorgefertigte Fertigkeiten, die einem Professor entsprechen. Ist auch kein Problem, passt wunderbar auf uns. Weiter geht's bei 128. Wir sind also nach wie vor im Erstellungsprozess, könnte man sagen. You realize Silas hasn't made a stop since the incident with the tractor. The motor coach winds its way uphill. However, your thoughts are interrupted as the road crests a ridge and you are treated to a magnificent view of the vista below. A creek sneaks through the valley, breaking the rich autumn palette of the tree line. In the distance, the white mountains rise into hazy cloud. There is no settlement, not even a cabin, as far as the eye can see. Birds drift to the treetops. And you can just make out what might be two white-tailed deer lingering by the water. Perhaps you are making a mistake by moving to the city. Could you survive on your own in this lush wilderness? You have a base ability in the most skills listed in the brackets after the skill name in the investigator sheet. Ja, das ist uns klar. For instance, you have 20% in climb and a base dodge equal to half of your dex. Stimmt das denn? Haben wir nur eine Grundchance in Klettern? Nein, wir haben Klettern 40. Das ist sehr gut. Okay, was können wir denn jetzt machen? Choose four skills which are not your occupation skills, nor Cthulhu Mythos. These are your personal interest skills. Boost each... Okay, wir können jetzt unsere Hobby-Skills... weiter verbessern. Hier ist nichts weiter zu tun, als weiter den Charakter auszubauen. Also gehen wir zu 144. Der einzige Abschnitt, wo es weitergeht. The motor coach rattles on through the hills and Silas lapses into silence. The sky darkens behind you, pinks tinting the clouds as the sun descends. Finally, a welcome sight comes into view, a settlement on the crest of the hill. This doesn't look like the pictures you have seen of Ossipi. But perhaps you can persuade Silas to stop while you stretch your legs. Minutes later, a harsh stuttering from the engine interrupts your reverie. Silas frowns and rattles at the gear stick. The motor coach falters in its ascent. Silas utters a curse you don't recognize and grinds his teeth, struggling at the wheel. You seem to inch up the hill until you reach the first buildings, low dwellings, constructed from a rough red stone. Silas wrestles the coach into a small bay of the road. He scrambles from his seat and makes for the engine compartment. You must now choose to make a roll against drive or psychology. If you choose drive auto, you need to roll equal or less than. Ja, gut, hier wird erklärt, wie man eine Probe macht. Das ist überhaupt kein Problem. Also, wir müssen entscheiden, ob wir eine Probe auf Autofahren machen oder ob wir eine Probe auf Psychologie machen. Warum Psychologie? Bei Psychologie können wir wahrscheinlich von Silas etwas erfahren. Hängt wahrscheinlich damit zusammen, wo wir hier sind, ne? Bei Autofahren bekommen wir wahrscheinlich das Auto wieder in Gang. Ja, wir versuchen es mal mit Psychologie. Das ist eine 37. Was haben wir in Psychologie? Eine 50. Okay. If you roll a hard success against psychology. Okay. Haben wir nicht. Gut, naja, dann müssen wir Autofahren machen. Was anderes bleibt uns hier nicht übrig. 24. Autofahren haben wir halt 20%, ne? 24, ach Mist, glatt versemmelt. Ah, if you fail your roll, go to 194. 194 ist also unser Abschnitt. Wir haben einfach alles versemmelt, was wir tun können. Jetzt schon. Silas opens the engine compartment and sticks his head inside. The hot metal pops and sizzles. He pokes at various components, then withdraws and wipes his brow, smearing it with dark grease. I ain't sure what's wrong. Might be the oil pressure. Might be something knocked off kilter when we took that spill. Can't do much until the engine cools neater. And with the light failing, I reckon we'll dare through the night, he whispers, his hand on a rack. The shadows from your surroundings are already long, and the air is chilly. You feel stiff from the journey, and the night in the rickety coach sounds unappealing. Silas sees your dismay. This here's Emberhead, miles from any place. I only come through twice a week, but the folks here are good people. May Ledbetter keeps a spare room. She will look after you. Up the alley. Turn right, first house on the left. He scratches his cheek, looks again into the engine compartment and spits on the ground. Meet me back here at 8 in the morning and we will see how we stand. Wenn der dann mal noch da ist, ne? Also, das Haus gehört May Ledbetter. Und Silas hat uns gerade gesagt, wir sollen dorthin gehen, zu diesem einsamen Haus und nach einem Bett fragen. Wir haben noch andere Möglichkeiten. To ask Silas where he will spend the night. Oh, das wäre eine wichtige Information. To challenge Silas about the breakdown. Okay, na gut, das werden wir jetzt nicht tun. Es ist nun mal passiert, also machen wir ihm jetzt auch nicht noch Vorwürfe. Dann, ja, wir fragen ihn mal, wo er denn die Nacht verbringen wird. 251. You ask about Silas' plans. He gives the engine a sour glance before answering. I've got acquaintances here in the village. Reckon one of them owes me a favor. Enough for bed and breakfast, in any case. He stares at his crumbly hands. Probably won't stretch to a hot bath. You don't seem to have a lot of options. You fetch your cases from the back of the motor coach. The least thing you need is for all your worldly possessions to disappear in some stranger's hovel overnight. Weiter bei 267. Also werden wir jetzt wahrscheinlich zu dem Haus gehen. You drag your cases between the sullen buildings. You feel surprisingly weary, considering you have spent all day sitting down. Silas' directions lead you to the modest dwelling with a slate roof. A nameplate reads Ledbetter, and underneath, a sign in neat copperplate reads Lodging Room. The lane around you is gloomy, but a lamp flickers in the window. A breeze chills your face. You are not about to begin your new life by sleeping in the street. You rap on the weather-beaten door. Go to 4. Klopfen wir also an der Tür und harren der Dinge, die da kommen. After a moment, you hear footsteps inside the house. A bolt is drawn back and the wooden door swings open. A figure with loose curls and a rough-looking house dress peers at you. Her gaze takes in your traveling suit and your cases. Her voice has a slight Irish lilt.
Hello, should I take it as you're looking for a room for the night?
You inquire as to her rate, suppressing a grimace. As far as you've seen, the village does not offer you many alternatives.
Oh, you'll find them very reasonable, she says. You look tired. I may. Come inside and we'll talk over a cup of tea.
The Ledbetter house feels cramped with a low ceiling and simple fittings. But it is well kept and a cheerful fire crackles in the grate. The aroma of tea is soothing and the cup warms your fingers.
Have you come to the Emberhead for the festival? Asks May.
To explain what happened with Silas and the coach, go to 14. To ask about the festival, go to 21. Okay, was tun wir als erstes? Na, sie hat uns mal nach dem Festival gefragt, also fragen wir jetzt mal, was das ist.
Well now, I suppose the festival is about the only reason folks come to Emberhead. I thought you had maybe come to study it or take photographs. Well, it's not tomorrow night, but the night after. I suppose it looks very strange to a passerby.
May tops up your tea. The sport chinks against your cup.
We've got the beacon, you see.
Also, das Leuchtfeuer, nicht den Speck.
One night every year, there's a torchlit procession and we light the beacon on the cliffs. You've never seen the like of it. They say it keeps the spirit of the village alive for another year. It's a celebration.
A celebration. She tails off for a moment and blinks.
But you didn't come here to listen to me blather, and you must be hungry. I can rustle you up a bit of stew. How would that be?
You ask again about her rates, and May names a price so low you accept it without hesitation. The room is small but comfortable, and the stew dark and hearty. After dinner, you have a couple of hours before your usual bedtime. Was können wir denn da machen? Also, sie verlangt fast nichts, dass wir hier bei ihr schlafen. Sie machen irgendeine Art von Prozession, um ein Leuchtfeuer zu entzünden und das morgen. Also, ja, sollten wir wahrscheinlich nicht mehr hier sein. Unsere Option. To talk to May some more, go to 31. To walk around and get your bearings, go to 75. To turn in for an early night. No. Nein, nein, nein. Das werden wir nicht tun. Sprechen wir jetzt gleich mit ihr weiter oder gehen wir etwas herum? Walk around and get your bearings. Das nehmen wir als erstes, denn reden können wir ja immer noch mit ihr. May's brow creases when you announce your intention to take a stroll.
Mind how you go, she says. Emberhead surrounded by cliffs, and we don't have your fancy street lamps here. Take the lantern and watch your step.
Outside, you see what she means. The sky is overcast, and only a few glimmers of moonlight peek from the clouds. Without the heavy lantern, you would be walking in near total darkness. You cannot hope to get an overview of the village tonight. May Street is a narrow passage, hemmed in by squat, dark dwellings. At the end, however, it opens up. A wide, true fair leads off to your right. A crude sign names it Silvery Street. To the left, a few yards away, your light picks out the crooked posts of a simple fence. And beyond that, the ground drops away into darkness. You take a couple of steps closer, but you can see nothing. Air from below cools your face. Then some instinct makes you look around. Go to 86. Bei 86 geht's also weiter. An ink-black figure stands in the road, about 20 yards behind you. It stares at you. You form the sudden impression that it will run at you and throw you over the cliff edge. This is unsettling. Seeing it has been spotted, the figure slips down an alley. Der wollte uns da hinunterwerfen. To return to the safety of the Ledbetter house,
Go to 100 to confront the dark figure. Go to 121. Ja, wir laufen der nach. Hallo, wir sind diese Art von Professor und wir haben einen Revolver. Wir schießen. As you approach, the figure takes a pace back, then another. It slips down an alley between two buildings. To catch a target, you must make a track roll. Okay, track. Was ist denn track? Wir haben hier nur verborgenes Erkennen. Spuren lesen hätten wir. Spurensuche. Spurensuche 10%? Naja, verborgenes Erkennen hätten wir 55%. Also meinen die hier wirklich Spurensuche? Oder ist das im Englischen einfach ein anderes Talent, das was anderes vereint? Naja, ich mache jetzt mal verborgenes Erkennen, denn das macht einfach mehr Sinn. Wir haben eine 5! Eine 5! Komplett egal, wir hätten beides geschafft. Auch Spurensuche hätten wir mit einer 5 geschafft. Und hier wird nichts angegeben, ob es ein extremer Erfolg sein kann oder ein schwieriger Erfolg. Muss nur geschafft sein. Also, if you succeed, go to 141. 141 geht's für uns weiter. The figure moves fast, with almost silent steps. But your instincts keep you on its tail. It slips through a dusty courtyard, veering off between iron fences. You close in as it darts around the corner. A breeze warns that you are close to the cliff edge. The flickering light from the lantern picks out its grassy lip as you charge in pursuit. You slow your pace, watching for unexpected voids beneath you. The watcher pulls further away, but rather than darting back onto the maze of street, it makes for the cliff edge. You close in. The dark figure swings its head to stare at you once more. You receive a brief, uneasy impression of something wrong with its face. Then it leaps over the cliff edge. Your mouth drops open. Der springt da runter. You approach the edge, lantern swinging in the wind. Dim light plays on the rock face beneath you. Did you frighten somebody into suicide? Your gut says not. But you cannot explain what just happened. Make a sanity roll. Okay, hier haben wir ihn. 49. Ist das noch? Wir haben 51 vom letzten Abenteuer. Ist kein Problem. Haben wir noch geschafft? You find your way back to the Ledbetter house, the lantern trembling in your grasp. If May notices your unease, she says nothing. You feel weary. Weiter bei 63. As May stands, you hear a clunk behind you. You look over your shoulder, but all you can see is a wooden door, securely closed. May tuts. The young lady of the house, she will have been listening to us. Ruth, come and greet our guest. There is a short pause, then the door creaks open. Two wide eyes peer at you from the gap, between tousled hair and a rough night groan. What do you say? The eyes blink. Please to meet you. Now get back to bed. The door closes again. My daughter Ruth, 10 years this summer. She's delight and torment all in one. Don't worry. She sleeps in with me. She will not disturb you. Good night now. You retire to your room. It is a little chilly, but you are too tired to worry about lighting a fire. The sheets are clean and the bed soon warms up. The silence outside is strange after living in a town for so long, but you soon drop off. Weiter bei 154. Was wird da passieren in der Nacht? You dream of a fire in the grate, coruscating colors shimmering through the dancing tongues of flame. At first they are tiny, almost microscopic, but they grow and grow, until a kaleidoscopic inferno spills from the fireplace, spreading across the floor, up the sheets. You wake with a start. Daylight glints through the curtains. You get up and examine the grate, blinking the sleep from your eyes. It is quite cold.
If you have taken any damage, you may heal one hit point back for your night's sleep.
Wir hätten schon Schaden bekommen können. Wo denn das?
Wir haben die Figur doch verfolgt. Und sie hat sich über die Klippe gestürzt. Was hätte uns denn da Schaden machen können?
Silas vielleicht, wenn wir wenn ihn vorgeworfen, sein Versagen vorgeworfen hätten mit dem Motor. Hätte uns vielleicht einen übergebraten, aber sonst.
Weiter bei 166. May seems to have no running water, but has supplied some in a ceramic jug.
Naja, wir sind sehr gewöhnt aus einem ägyptischen Gefängnis, ne?
You freshen up at the washstand and go in. She cooks a hearty breakfast and leaves you in peace to eat. About 7:30, you're paid up, packed and ready to go. You bid May goodbye and she wishes you the best for your new career in Arkham. If you succeeded at a skill roll last night and wish to investigate the results further, go to 178, otherwise go to 192.
Wenn wir einen Fertigkeitswurf geschafft haben letzte Nacht, das haben wir. Und wir haben auch was gesehen. Kann nur das gemein sein. Denn in der tatsächlichen Nacht haben wir geschlafen. Ne? Da konnten wir ja nichts anderes machen. Also gehen wir jetzt mal zu 178 und sehen, ob wir da noch irgendwas herausfinden können.
You retrace your steps of last night. A few villagers watch with polite curiosity as you thread your way along the northern cliffs, backs in town. In time you think you have found the spot. Heart thudding in your chest, you peer over the edge. Nothing.
Es ist also doch das, da hat er sich runtergeworfen und wir sehen nichts.
With the benefit of daylight, you see the cliff is not the bottomless drop you imagined. It leads to a shelf some 20 yards below. It could still be a lethal tumble, but you see no body and no blood.
Make a spot hidden roll. Ha! Darauf freue ich mich immer ganz besonders. Verborgenes Erkennen, da haben wir 55.
9! Das ist eine glatte 9! Das ist sogar ein extremer Erfolg.
Oh, man kann es auch wieder nur ganz normal bestehen. Wir haben es geschafft. Wir dürfen zu 112. Irgendetwas wird uns jetzt auffallen.
112. Your keen eyes pick it up after a couple of minutes of scanning the cliff face. There are a series of protruding rocks combined with that look like man-made incisions. The effect is an ingenious hidden stairway that lets down the cliff. No doubt the dark figure used this to descend safely.
Da waren Stufen drin. Der ist überhaupt nicht runtergesprungen, der ist einfach Stufen runtergegangen.
You look along the lower shelf. You see only a few drop shacks off to your right. This might have been an interesting find, where you're not about to leave Emberhead for good.
Ja, da sollten wir wirklich weg.
Der ist da einfach nur runtergegangen. Oh.
You discovered a secret. If you ever need to climb or descend this northeasterly cliff, the text will offer you a hint. At the point, if you want to try the staircase, add 100 to your current entry number and go to the new entry point.
Okay, wann immer wir da etwas Northeasterly Cliff zu tun haben, können wir 100 zur Abschnittsnummer dazu zählen und dorthin gehen.
Oh, das ist ja cool.
If the new entry does not seem to fit, you should return to your original entry and carry on.
Okay, müssen wir also ausprobieren.
Restore one sanity point. You may checkmark the small box beside the spot hidden skill.
Sehr schön, das können wir dann steigern beim nächsten Mal. Verborgenes erkennen. Na gut, das gleiche mache ich aber mit Spurensuche, denn die haben wir auch geschafft, ne?
Weiter geht's bei 192. You are already tired of your heavy bags. Hopefully Silas has repaired the motor coach and you can resume your long journey. A Zorpas he might be, but the old driver seemed to understand his vehicle well enough. You pause to check your watch. Still 20 minutes early and around the final corner. The motor coach is gone. Das war so klar, dass der weg ist, ne? You put your bags down and search the area, tracking up and down slopes and around corners. At the edge of the village, you trace a long road back as it winds across the hills. 8 o'clock comes and goes. There is no coach to be seen. A passing villager notices your bags.
Looking after the bus? I heard him take off at first light. He's due back in 3 or 4 days. If you need a place to stay, may let better. Rent a room.
The man raises his head to you and strolls on into the village. Ah, da ist doch was im Gange. Ich soll da hin zu dir, ne? Ach Gott.
You curse Silas under your breath. Perhaps he went for parts. But you wonder if the old goat has stranded you here on purpose.
Ach Gott, genau das hat er getan. Er hat uns hier abgesetzt. 218 geht's weiter. Gut, dass wir unseren Revolver haben.
May is doing laundry and looks surprised to see you again.
Forgot something?
When you explain the situation, she offers to store your bags while you try to arrange alternative transport. You are grateful to relinquish the load.
Nobody here has anything like a car.
She strokes her chin and narrows her eyes.
Maybe you could find somebody with a horse and a cart for your bags. I could ask around later. Try Mr. Winters at the village hall. He will know if anyone will. Or ask among the artisans. The workshops are first left on Silver Street.
She reaches over and squeezes your wrist.
Don't worry. I won't see you sleeping in the street, money or no money.
You thank May and turn to face the village.
Oh, wir sollten einfach weglaufen. Go to 6.
Bei 6 geht's weiter.
You wander the streets of Emberhead without any particular destination in mind. The village is built on a relatively flat upland with splendid views. To the north, the hazy tips of the White Mountains reach for the heavens. To the south, the sparkling waters of Lake Winnipesaukee touch the horizon. The village itself takes less than 5 minutes to cross from edge to edge. You arrive on the winding road to the west. The only other road leaves to the south, following a lower ridge of land as it turns east. In the southwest of the village, an open grassy space borders a ruined church, its graveyard cresting the cliffs. To the northeast, the three main thoroughfares meet at a raised black metal structure. It looms, stark against the blue sky. You may now ask about transport at the local general store. Seek out the village hall, walk down to the lower level and check out the eastern road.
Oh, hier geht's noch weiter.
Examine the large metal structure.
Das wird wahrscheinlich irgend sowas, irgendeine Vorrichtung für das Leuchtfeuer sein, könnte ich mir vorstellen.
Explore the church, das will ich unbedingt machen. Look for local people with their own transport needs.
Okay. Ich fürchte fast, dass uns hier niemand irgendwo hin transportieren wird. Wir sehen uns mal die Kirche an, 34.
You cross the street towards the church. As you glance to your left, your gaze aligns on the large metal structure. Something bothers you about its positioning. You back up and look again. Yes, Emberhead's central thoroughfare points directly at the structure. It seems too precise to be coincidence. You press on and draw into the shadow of the church. The building is in a sorry state. The top of the steeple is missing, a ragged gash of splintered boards marking its absence, and the floors beneath it have collapsed. It appears to have torn through the roof of the main building as it fell. Only the back half is still intact, with white paint, which once covered the church, has yellowed and peeled. It seems safe enough to explore the rear section. Old pews are stacked against the wall, choked with mildew. Most of the windows are broken. You guess this church has been disused for about 20 years. There's little more to interest you.
Make a ride roll? Warum denn jetzt reiten? Okay, aber machen wir es halt. Da haben wir eine Grundchance, ne? Ungefähr 5% oder so. Ja, 7. Wir würfeln heute so gut. Das ist heftig, aber ja, 7 sind nicht 5, also nicht geschafft.
Dann geht's weiter bei 25. Ich weiß halt oft nicht, ob ich die englischen Skill-Bezeichnungen richtig lese oder ob das im Deutschen halt einfach zu etwas anderem wurde. You are beginning to get your bearings in Amberhead. Would you like to explore some more? Of course, natürlich wollen wir mehr untersuchen. You may choose another option from those below. Do not repeat the previous choice. Ja, das ist klar. And once you have tried four options, go to three. Okay, wir können also nur vier von den aufgeführten sechs versuchen. Wir haben also die erste versucht, bleiben noch drei. Also jetzt möchte ich auf jeden Fall mal nach einem Transportmittel fragen. Also scheint mir Ask about transport at a local general store eine gute Alternative zu sein. Geht's weiter bei 16. The general store is on a corner beside the main road, just before it plunges to the south. The shopkeeper is a brisk, immense lady with a starched apron and strong shoulders. She looks hard at your unfamiliar face. Transport? There's a motor coach. Comes through twice a week. Missed it? Hmm. Truck brings in my supplies every second Tuesday, but is not due until next week. She shrugs. It seems Amberhead is content to keep its distance from the outside world. You have enough money to buy one or two inexpensive everyday items here. Note them down on your investigator sheet. Remember, the year is 1927. Ja, bei uns muss es eigentlich 1932 sein, weil wir ja mit dem Professor weiterspielen. Aber egal, wir können hier zwei Dinge kaufen. Zwei normale Dinge. Wir haben hier eine Umhängetasche, also wir haben unseren Revolver dabei. Ich weiß nicht, ob es wichtig ist, aber wir kaufen uns auf jeden Fall ein Feuerzeug und eine Fackel. Feuerzeug und Fackel. Nein. Wir kaufen uns eine Peitsche. Wir kaufen uns eine Peitsche und ein Feuerzeug. Das kaufen wir uns. Das tun wir. Wir haben jetzt eine Peitsche. Und die geht als Seil durch. Das wisst ihr, ne? Okay, dann geht's weiter bei 25. Ja, sind wir wieder zurück. Wir haben nun zwei Locations untersucht. Können wir noch zwei machen? Examine the large metal structure. Das werden wir auf jeden Fall tun. 57, die können wir halt einfach nicht ignorieren. Ne? You walk up to approach the most central of the village's major streets. It points directly at the odd metal structure. As you emerge from the shade of the nearby buildings, you are greeted by a magnificent panorama spread from the north to the southeast. The last colors of fall tint the hills in a sleepy gold. The structure, by contrast, is made from uncompromising iron, signed black. It supports an immense curved platform at the level of your head. Further struts sneak up to a central point. It looks like they may have been some kind of sculpture at one time, but are now twisted and melted beyond recognition. An older gentleman passes, looking up at you. Are you here for the festival? He asks. That's the bacon. When they light it, night after next, you will be able to see it 10 miles away. He gives a little nod of satisfaction, then moves on, leaning on his walking stick. Now you notice bundles of wood tied and stacked against the buildings nearby. Perhaps this festival would be an interesting diversion. But you really must head to Arkham as soon as possible. Oh, nein. Wir bleiben nicht für dieses Festival. Ja, aber ja, es war mir irgendwie klar, dass das das Leuchtfeuer sein wird. Oh, make a spot hidden roll. Okay, wir können wieder Verborgenes erkennen. 50, ganz genau. Wie viel haben wir? 55. Oh Gott. If you succeed, wir haben es geschafft. Geht's weiter bei 69. Wir finden irgendwas raus. As you walk away from the iron structure, you notice something strange about the construction of the village. All the wooden dwellings are concentrated in the west and southeast. To the east and northeast, closest to the beacon, the buildings are formed from dark brick and clay. Does this mean the settlement began at the Bacon and spread west? Okay. Sagt uns das jetzt etwas, wenn die die Siedlung am Leuchtfeuer gebaut haben und es sich dann ausgebreitet hat? You may checkmark the small box beside spot hidden rule. Ja, haben wir schon gemacht, können wir nicht nochmal tun. Dann gehen wir wieder zurück zu 25. Können wir noch eine letzte Sache tun, ne? Eine letzte Sache. Okay. Seek out the village hall. Ich wüsste jetzt nicht, was ich da tun soll. Walk down to the lower level and check out the eastern road. Das werden wir noch tun. Einfach um zu sehen, was da ist und ob wir da Hilfe finden können. 115. The air is fresh and the walk down to the lower ridge invigorating. You notice cultivated fields stretching through the lowlands around Emberhead. And among the crops, some livestock, but no horses. Wäre ja auch irgendwie zu einfach gewesen, ne? Are you going to have to make your onward journey on foot? Further down, the road skirts the edge of the ridge and descends. There are a few scattered houses here, with signs of habitation. They are set a substantial distance apart. As you examine them, a door opens and an older man steps out. He wears a bedraggled suit, but carries a piece of cloth, which he tossed over his head like a hood. As he does this, he sees you and freezes. Haben wir jemand erwischt, der nicht erwischen werden wollte? Make a luck roll. Okay, das tun wir. Wir haben Glück. 51 ist schon etwas runtergegangen. 51! Ich habe genau 51 gewürfelt. Ha, das zählt. Und wie das zählt. If you succeed, turn to 127. Geht's weiter für uns. 127. Da ist es. The man looks up the village, scanning the clifftops. You get a brief flash of his face. There is something unsettling about it. Then he turns to walk away from the road. But as he does, he raises a hand and slowly beckons to you. Er winkt uns also. If you follow the strange man, turn to 142. If this seems unwise, oh nein, 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 wir tun das jetzt. Vielleicht finden wir da was heraus. 142. You follow the man around the outcrop. He glances up, then steps between the rocks and vanishes. Closer inspection reveals a narrow channel leading into the cliff. There is just enough light to see a small natural chamber within. You will be uncomfortable close to this man if you go inside. If you follow him, turn to 191. Wir gehen zu 191, wir folgen ihm. Was haben die da in den Cliffs versteckt? With weary steps you squeeze between rocky outcrops and enter the concealed chamber, almost banging your head on the low ceiling. The man settles back against the wall and watches until you draw close. Then he slits back his hood. Make a sanity roll.
Okay, so schlimm.
62. Ah, das haben wir sowas von nicht geschafft, ne? Ach Gott, Stabilität haben wir auch 51. If you fail, lose one sanity. Okay. Gut, dann haben wir jetzt noch 50 Stabilität und so oder so geht's weiter bei 199. Some of the man's face remains. A strip from the side of his jaw to his right eye socket is healthy and pale, if aged. But the left side is consumed by angry scar tissue. One eye drops hooded by melted flesh, and the nostril on the side is pulled open to leave a gaping hole. The disfigured man studies your reaction with his one good eye.
Name's Arbogast. Willard Arbogast. Guess I don't need to ask what brings you to Amberhead.
If you claim to have come for the festival, sind wir nicht. If you admit that Silas has stranded you here, go to 214.
Okay, der hat Brandnarben, ne, über dem kompletten Gesicht.
That swollen mouth gives a little twist downwards.
Son of a bitch has red blood. His fingers tighten into a fist.
weiter bei 221. Er hat uns also in die Falle gelockt, der Silas. Arbogast fixes you with a lopsided yet intense stare. You seek me out, eh? He looks up at the cave ceiling. Which one of them told you about me? Never mind. It don't matter. Truth is, they fear what I know. They would never come at me direct. Don't want to end up like old Arbogast. He giggles. The high-pitched sound is all the more grotesque, coming from those bloated lips. Then abruptly, his gaze turns into iron. Amber had died 40 years ago, shattered by flame, consumed by the stars themselves. The ancient hill was cleansed by inferno, and from the blackened ground came new life, as it is the way of all things. The Abenaki knew. Arbogast wipes his nose on his sleeve. Except none of that happens. The flames are turned away, the necessary death postponed a year and a year again. And now those up there, he steps a scrawny finger at the ceiling, think themselves saviors of the village. Think they can defy the great old ones. Yeah, Ktuga. He shakes his head. With strange eons, their lives matter less than the blink of an eye. A fiercy intelligence burns in his gaze. But you suspect Arbogast may be quite insane. Should his mood change, it would not be difficult for him to seize one of the loose rocks and crack your skull with it.
Oh nein, nein, ich glaube, der ist der Einzige, der bei Verstand ist.
Okay, wir können. To ask Arbogast about the Abenaki, to ask him about the great old ones, to ask him about the villages, to leave while you still can.
Ja, nein, nein, nein. Wir fragen als erstes nach den Abenaki. Wir fragen uns sowieso komplett durch. Ich hoffe mal, dass wir es können.
The Abenaki, he frowns. They knew this land and cherished it. They lived here in harmony for their allotted time. Air and earth, water and fire. They accepted every daybreak as a gift. And they trod lightly on the land. Yet we came and we ended them. Their time is past. Now ours too must end. Arbogast runs a hand through his hair. A white strip is missing on the left side, displaced by scar tissue. He climbs to his feet. Weiter bei 259.
Ich hoffe, wir können jetzt noch was fragen.
Arbogast pauses in the shadows. There's something about you. Something the previous ones never had. Perhaps you can make it through. If you want to hear more, meet me again after dark. 9 o'clock. The graveyard on the other side. He lifts a gnarled finger. Don't be followed, else I won't be there. This ain't the time of the year for a showdown. Arbogast wipes his nose on his sleeve again. Go now, their eyes are on me. And stranger, don't try to run. You will never make it.
You emerge into the sunlight, blinking and more than a little shaken. You have discovered a secret. Later tonight, the text will offer you a chance to follow up on a previous appointment. At that point, if you want to meet with Arbogast again, add 20 to your current entry number and go to the new entry. Okay, müssen wir 20 dazu rechnen.
Jetzt geht's weiter bei 160 und das war's dann auch schon mit unseren 4 Entscheidungen. Aber wir wissen ja jetzt etwas, ne?
You turn back to the road and your core business, getting out of Amberhead and onwards to Ossipee. The ridge gives you a good viewpoint from which you can see the course of the road. It winds with the hills, disappearing into woodland for a while before emerging further on. You lose sight of it somewhere towards the second patch of woodland. By your best estimation, that is at least 6 or 7 miles distant. You see no other settlements or traffic. It may be worth taking a chance and walking. The weather is still mild. But you will need supplies before you attempt it.
Weiter bei 25. Können wir das? Können wir da einfach rausgehen?
You are beginning to get your bearings in Amberheads. Would you like to explore some more? Okay. Ja, wir haben jetzt vier Optionen durch. Ne? Wir sind zur Kirche, wir sind zum Leuchtfeuer, wir sind zu einem Local General Store und ja, wir haben Arbogast getroffen. Also geht's jetzt weiter bei Nummer 3. Your morning exertions have left you hungry. You roam the streets of Amberhead looking for sustenance. There is nothing resembling the busy cafes of your hometown or anything that might be called a restaurant. It is beginning to look like you will have to get supplies from the general store when May Ledbetter comes down the street with a girl trailing in her wake. This must be Ruth. As she notices you, she races past her mother and approaches you with a smile. This is a different Ruth from the shy creature of last night. As she reaches you, she stops and stretches her arms up in celebration. She looks up into your eyes. Abruptly, the smile drops from her face and she looks several years older. Get out before the festival, she hisses. Get out! She blinks hard, then scuttles back towards her mother. May approaches, wrapping an arm around her daughter's shoulders. She smiles. How are you getting on? Have you found transport? Startled, you explain the frustration of the situation. I would try Mr. Winters in the village hall, but you must be hungry by now. Help yourself to any food in the house. The door is not locked. You glance at Ruth, where she has squirreled herself behind her mother's leg. Her eyes implore you to silence. If you ask Ruth about what she said, nein, nein, das tun wir nicht. Wir wissen ja mittlerweile genug, dass wir das nicht tun. Die will uns helfen. If you ask May about, nein, nein, wir sagen da gar nichts. If you say nothing, das tun wir. If you say nothing. 22 geht's weiter für uns. You take your leave to the Ledbetters and head towards their house. The door opens easily. In the low kitchen, you make a meal from soggy bread and leftover stew. A little window offers a view to the mountains. If you learned one thing this morning, it was that Amberhead streets hold little to occupy the visitor from out of town. But there is still about 5 hours of daylight remaining. You could take some provisions and the bare essentials from your luggage and set out in the hope of reaching another settlement before dark. Or you could ask advice from this Mr. Winters. Okay, also jetzt ist die Frage, ne? Wenn wir diesem Arbogast vertrauen, dann versuchen wir jetzt nicht wegzulaufen. Denn die kriegen uns wahrscheinlich, nehme ich mal an. Ach, das ist jetzt wahrscheinlich so ein Keypoint, ne? Die Frage ist, wenn wir versuchen wegzulaufen, nur weil Arbogast das nicht gesagt hat, dass wir das nicht tun sollen, werden wir dann automatisch eingefangen und sind tot? Oder könnten wir da auch entkommen? Ja, wir sind bewaffnet, wir haben einen Revolver, ne? Und ja, ich denke, also ich will jetzt schon versuchen, mir Essen in die Umhängetasche zu packen und einfach mal loszugehen. If you prepare and walk out of town, go to 28. Okay, wir versuchen das jetzt mal. Wir versuchen das. Wir packen zusammen und gehen raus. You take money, water and some sandwiches. It seems polite to leave May Ledbetter a note explaining the situation and that you will return for your bags as soon as possible. Die sehen wir nie wieder, das Gepäck. The sky is flecked with clouds, but shows no sign of imminent rain. A couple of villagers watch as you descend on the southern road and follow it around to the east. Oh, können wir uns da nicht verstecken? Jetzt ziehen die uns, ne? The black metal structure looms on the promontory above. You shiver as you pass the lower huts and head out of Amberhead. After the miserable and closed streets of Amberhead, you are refreshed by the open air and sense of progress. An hour later, however, the empty road ceases to be a novelty. You have just entered the first patch of woodland when you hear an eerie lilting howl from the north. Make a roll if you succeed. Go to 35, if you fail. Go to 41. Make a roll. Okay. Ach Gott, hier ist vergessen worden, was wir denn würfeln sollen. Schauen wir mal, ob es denn wichtig ist. Make a roll. Okay, das ist eine 5. 40, das wäre schon wichtig, ne? Ich habe halt keine Ahnung. Also, okay, was wollen wir hier tun? Wir wollen uns verstecken. Das ist immer eine gute Option. Was haben wir verborgen bleiben? Haben wir 50. Haben wir also mit einer 40 geschafft. Also sagen wir jetzt mal, wir haben es geschafft und gehen zu 35. The call is that of a coyote, common in this area. The sounds can be frightening, particularly at night, but coyotes have learned to avoid humans. You can proceed without fear. Okay, das war also kein Verstecken-Roll gemeint. Wir hätten irgendwas in der Art von Tierkunde oder so haben sollen. Egal, jetzt wissen wir das. You may checkmark the small box beside the natural world skill. Okay, das hätten wir würfeln sollen. Ist egal, jetzt wissen wir es. Wir gehen zu 54. A second call answers the first, but it sounds further away. You follow the road through woodland. Branches lean over the road. The foliage is quite beautiful, from gold to russet and a deep, rich red. Fallen leaves crunch beneath your feet. After about half an hour, you emerge from the trees. The road makes a lazy curve around foothills ahead into another patch of woodland. A rough track seems to offer a shortcut through the woods. Okay, sind wir also mitten im Wald? Die können uns ja nicht wirklich verfolgen, oder? Unsere Möglichkeiten. If you head up the hill to try to spot another settlement, das wäre 60. If you try the track, oder if you stick to the safety of the road. Okay, man kann uns halt leicht folgen, wenn wir auf der Straße bleiben. Was ist, wenn wir diesen anderen Weg entlang gehen? Ach Gott, die Straße wäre halt gut, ne? Da kommen wir irgendwann dann raus. Ja, wir gehen mal dem Hügel rauf und sehen, ob wir da irgendetwas überblicken können. The gentle incline is misleading and your forehead is damp by the time you reach the top of the hill. You pause for a moment to get your breath back and look east. The valley ahead is thick with forest. Also, you catch glimpses of a narrow waterway. There is still no sign of a settlement. That might be something in the horizon. A spire? Maybe. But it is surely another 8 or 9 hours walk. You look back at Amberhead. The hilltop village is black. A rough silhouette against the shimmering orb of sunset. You may make an archaeology roll. Ha! Archäologie! Das können wir natürlich. Wir haben eine 6. Nein, wir können es nicht. Ach Gott, warum können wir keine Archäologie? Oh, wir haben 0. Wir haben eine 1% Chance bei Archäologie. Aber wir können Hieroglyphen lesen. Okay, das habe ich dann falsch verstanden. Ach Gott. Aber. Hier können wir Glück ausgeben, ne? Ich habe eine 6 gewürfelt, also das zahlt sich aus. Wir geben auf alle Fälle 5 Punkte Glück aus und haben es dann geschafft. Haben wir noch 46 Glück. Okay, geht's für uns weiter bei 66. The position of the sun bothers you. It reminds you of something from one of the journals, an article about stone circles in England. You check your position with the mountains in the north, closing your eyes to visualize the layout of Amberhead from the explorations this morning. The metal structure is the key, positioned on the bluff as it is. Yes, it seems entirely possible. You can't be sure without taking a proper bearing and consulting the tables, of course, but if your guess is correct, the central thoroughfare in Amberhead is positioned so that during the summer solstice, the rays of the rising sun will shine through the metal structure and directly down the center of the street. Perhaps this is just wild speculation, but something feels correct about it. Aber wie kann ich das jetzt benutzen? Okay, wir können uns Archäologie ankreuzen. Können wir steigern? Geht's weiter bei 79? Wir wollen ja nur fliehen. You return your road and resume your walk east. At least you hope that you are still heading east. The curves of the road become disorienting when the light begins to fade.
clouds hide the stars. It seems you will not reach another settlement before dark, and you feel weariness in your legs. The air is much cooler now. Make a listen roll. Ha! Wir können horchen.
Das haben wir hoffentlich. Haben wir das Horchen?
20 nur! Ach Gott! Oh, das ist eine 39. Ich will das aber schaffen. Ich will das jetzt schaffen. Ach Gott. 19 Punkte Glück. Ah, die haben wir noch, ne? Haben wir noch 27 Glück. Ach Gott. Naja, aber wir haben es geschafft. Wir können weiter bei 240. Aber wenn wir da raus wollen, ist das jetzt sehr, sehr wichtig, denke ich.
You hear something from the road behind you. It is a dull clunk. Perhaps a dead branch falling. You pause, but the sound does not repeat. You retrace a few paces and look down the road. There is nothing to see.
Okay, wir können uns horchen ankreuzen. Ja, aber das rettet uns vermutlich nicht. 234 geht's weiter.
Another cry splits the gloom. It is the same unearthly call you heard when you entered the first patch of woodland, but this time with a grating undertone that makes you shiver. It seems closer. To take refuge in a tree for the night, go to 208. To keep walking,
wir klettern auf den Baum. Wir klettern auf den Baum. Mehr muss ich gar nicht lesen.
The echoing call comes again, and this time it is answered by something closer to you. It seems a good time to get off the ground. You select a tree with obvious footholds and a thick branch at about twice your height. You hold yourself up. You are not dressed for this.
Was soll denn das heißen? Wir haben sogar eine Peitsche, mit der wir uns behelfen können. 36, was habe ich denn überhaupt klettern? 40, och, wieder so knapp.
Okay, wir haben es geschafft. 228 geht's für uns weiter. You ease yourself onto the widest branch you can see. It is less than comfortable, but you do at least feel safer in this elevated position. Night settles slowly around you. The woods come alive with small noises, scratching nearby, distant bird calls, and a gentle rustle of leaves. Also, resigned to a long, tedious night of wakefulness, after a few hours, you find yourself yawning. You loop your belt around the branch and your clothing to hold yourself in place as best you can. Then you close your eyes. Und hier werden wir eine kurze Pause machen. Bis gleich.
Herzlich willkommen zurück bei Alone Against the Flames. Es ist ein sehr, sehr schönes Abenteuer, macht mir wahnsinnig viel Spaß. Es ist sehr ungewohnt für mich, das auf Englisch zu machen, aber auch da werde ich besser werden mit der Zeit. Weiter geht's für uns bei 246.
In your dreams, the trees change position, lifting their roots from the ground and shuffling to another spot before planting themselves again. This seems perfectly normal, companionable even. They start to glow, a greenish, yellow as flames, like
flames?
The trees begin to scream. Tongues of flickering fire sneak up the tree towards you. You're scrabbling at the belt which binds you to this pyre, coughing as the vapors fill your throat, choking. Make a sanity roll.
Nur einen sanity roll? Ne, das ist ein Traum, ne? 39! Okay, das haben wir geschafft.
If you succeed, go to 252 ist der nächste Abschnitt. Something is not right here. Even as your fingers find the clasp of the belt and open it, some rational part of your mind recognizes that this fire does not look natural. And trees don't move by themselves. The belt releases and you drop through air. Can you see figures there? Coming out of the dark.
Okay, das ist ja auch keine Frage. Ich kann überhaupt nichts würfeln. Ich
verliere nur 1W3 Lebenspunkte. 1, das ist schon mal sehr, sehr gut, denn wir haben nicht viel, wir haben nur 9. Jetzt haben wir 8 und dann geht es weiter bei 13. Sind uns die jetzt wirklich, haben die uns jetzt wirklich aufgespürt, die Dorfbewohner?
The skin of your face feels warm. There's a mattress beneath you. You blink against the sunlight. A blurred figure swims in your vision.
You're awake? It's May.
May Ledbetter, oh Gott. You shift and pain wrecks your body. You feel bruised and your head drops. May comes into focus.
You're lucky to be alive. A farmer found you in the small hours lying by the road, patched you up and brought you back on his cart. Said you were in the middle of the wood somewhere. Best take it easy. I'll look in on you later.
The farmer and his cart are long gone, of course. You snooze for a little longer. You have received first aid while unconscious and may restore 1 hit point.
Okay, sind wir wieder bei 9. Dann geht es jetzt zu 64 und wir haben vermutlich unser Treffen mit Ardo Gast verpasst, was sehr schlecht für uns ist. Also fangen die uns also doch einfach ein und wir können da nichts dagegen tun.
The Ledbetter kitchen is empty, although bread and eggs have been laid out for your breakfast. There is a note from May explaining that she has taken roof out for a few hours. If you were involved in a fight in the village last night and want to investigate the aftermath, go to 70.
Nein, waren wir nicht. Otherwise, to 78. Nein, wir haben blöderweise Arbogast verpasst.
You make a quiet circuit of the village, pausing in unobtrusive places to watch the villagers. It is rather busy for this time in the morning. Yawning locals streaming back and forward along the roads, carrying bundles of split logs to the site of what you've heard referred as the beacon. You see 2 figures already up in its superstructure, arranging the wood. The festival bonfire will be most impressive.
But do you intend to stay to see it?
You suspect that now that something is amiss here. While the villagers are distracted, you may do some illicit investigation. Or you may simply leave town without looking back.
Ja, das haben wir ja schon versucht, ne? Okay, also wir können search May Ledbetter's bedroom, go alone to the village hall, take a closer look at the artisan's courtyard, spy on the activity at the beacon, slip down to the east road and flee for good.
Naja, jetzt müssen wir dabei bleiben, ne? Jetzt müssen wir dabei bleiben. Jetzt laufen wir weg.
Aber vielleicht finden wir was in May Ledbetter's bedroom.
Ah, da gehen wir zuerst rein.
83. Despite her hospitality, you do not trust May Ledbetter. You return to her house quite openly. Where else would you go? Inside, the dwelling is still empty. You rap on the bedroom door and wait. Silence. You ease it open. The Ledbetter bedroom is in marked contrast to your own neat space. Dirty cloths are piled about the floor. On a rough quilt lie school books and cheap novels. You noticed a raggedy old doll discarded from the side of the bed.
Make a spot hidden roll. Okay, das können wir hier tun. 66, das ist nicht geschafft, ne? Okay, naja, haben wir nicht geschafft. Geht's weiter bei 89.
You go through the Ledbetter's drawers. The only item of interest you find is a wedding photograph. May's husband is a weary man with a square chin. Despite the formality of the pose, you can see the affection between them. You feel a pang of guilt at your intrusion. Also, May might return at any time.
Okay, aber wir können ihn forcieren. Wir können Spot Hidden forcieren. Naja, müssen wir, ne? Wir können nicht immer alles nur halbherzig machen. Also, jetzt muss es klappen. 46! Tut es das? 46? Verborgenes Erkennen 55. Okay, boah. Das haben wir geschafft. 95. Gut, 95 geht's für uns weiter.
You notice scraps on the floorboards corresponding to the legs of the bed. With effort, you slide the bed away. There is a rug spread beneath it, and beneath the rug, a trap door. You ease it open. The dark space beneath is some kind of cellar. To descend into the cellar, go to 114.
Och Gott, wir hätten laufen sollen, aber wahrscheinlich hat das auch nichts gebracht, ne? Also wir gehen da runter in diesen Keller. Vielleicht führt uns das hier raus.
The daylight barely offers enough illumination to see, but a hot lantern during daytime would be very suspicious. You squeeze beneath the floor and glance around. Your first impression is that May keeps her junk here, for there are many boxes of different sizes piled in untidy heaps. It takes a few seconds before you realize they are all traveling trunks and suitcases. There are about 20 of them.
Ach Gott, ist klar, ne? Alle Reisende verschwinden hier und die hat die Koffern bei ihr unten.
The implication hits you hard, yet you maintain enough control to check the luggage tags. You count 8 or 9 different names before you stop. Scrambling back up to the bedroom, you close the trapdoor with trembling fingers, returning to the bed to its place.
Jetzt laufen wir einfach nur noch. Wir schießen uns den Weg da raus.
You feel a deepening unease about Amberhead and this day in particular. Once you have attempted 3 of the options below, go to 98. Otherwise, you may search the bedroom, das haben wir getan, go along to the village hall, haben wir getan, take a closer look at the artisan's courtyard, haben wir getan, spy at the beacon, slip down to the east road and flee for good.
Das ist das Einzige, das jetzt noch Sinn macht. Wir laufen und wenn es sein muss, schießen wir uns unseren Weg frei.
As you approach the southern road that descends to the lower ridge, you see 4 villagers blocking the route with farm tools and clubs.
Ich habe einen Revolver mit 6 Schuss, haha.
You veer off and head towards the west road.
Nein, wir schießen.
Your heart sinks as you see exactly the same scene at the other exit from the village. You are trapped. Try to talk your way past one of the guard groups. Try to slip past in disguise. Or do you know another way to leave the village?
Do ich? Ach so, das ist. Hier ist keine Abschnittsnummer angegeben. Ne? Also das ist sowas, wo ich etwas zum Abschnitt dazu zählen muss. Aber das tun wir. Das tun wir. Die 100. Wir müssen 100 dazu zählen. Ne? Das waren der Weg. Über die Klippen, den wir am Anfang gefunden haben, ne? Diese Stufen. Okay, wir versuchen das jetzt mal. Wir sind bei Abschnitt 7 und wenn wir da jetzt 100 dazu zählen und zu 107 kommen, hilft uns das?
The Cliffside Staircase! Ja, es hilft uns! You melt back into the village. Eyes follow you as you go. Eventually you head back towards the Ledbetter house with a visible yawn. Alone for the moment, you slip down an alley and thread your way around the rear of the buildings. You find the spot and slip your feet over the side, feeling for the step and trying not to think of the 20-foot drop beneath you. You grip the cold stone of the cliff, one step down, then another. Somebody rounds a nearby building and you pull your head out of sight. 60 seconds later, your feet touch soil ground. The shacks nearby are shuttered. You move with light steps to the eastern road.
152 geht's weiter. Ha! Wir kommen da raus!
The sun is low in the sky as you head east from the village, making for the safety of the woods. The beacon breaks the horizon, imposing in silhouette. You maintain as fast a pace as you can until you reach the refuge of the tree line. Then you allow yourself to step off the road and take a breath. Almost 2 hours later, the sun sets. The darkness of the woods might be frightened, but your escape from Amberhead has given you new resolve. You strike into the night. Not long afterwards, you hear hoofs approaching fast. 2 sets. Your heart lifts, but they are coming from behind you. Die kommen mir also nach. Make a stealth roll. Okay, was haben wir? In verborgen bleiben 50. Das ist eine 50-50 Chance. Und wir haben noch ziemlich viel Glück. Naja, ziemlich viel nicht mehr. Noch 27 Glück. Ja, das schaffen wir. 30! Überhaupt kein Problem. Das ist fast ein schwieriger Erfolg. Wir gehen zu 211. You press yourself against the biggest trunk you can find. Two horses draw near, their riders holding up lanterns. Branches cast a maze of shifting shadows across you as they pass. You get a momentary look at the face of one rider. He looks drawn and anxious. Then they head away to the east. Once you are sure they're out of earshot, you make your way through the woods. It seems wise to avoid the road. Das werden wir ganz sicher tun. Okay, wir können jetzt auch verborgen bleiben, ankreuzen. Dann geht's weiter bei 223. Sind wir jetzt raus? You emerge into the hilltop and take a moment to check your bearings. The sun will set in the west behind Emberhead, so you need to heed. As you looked at the village several miles away now, you see the beacon ablaze, an orange glow that lights up the sky and the surrounding woodland. Smoke billows towards the heavens, where the stars form a twinkling canopy against the midnight blue of eternity. You watch the scene for a few minutes, then turn away to continue your journey. For a moment, you are left with a strange impression. You thought that as you turned, one of the stars above the village moved. But that would be madness. Congratulations! Wir haben's geschafft! You have survived this adventure. You may keep your investigator sheet and use it in another Call of Cthulhu scenario. If you have checkmarked the small box beside any skill, you will have a chance to improve them through experience. Wir können also steigern. The end. Wir haben's geschafft. Alone against the flames. Wir sind also entkommen. Oh, ich hätte es nicht mehr gedacht. Oh, ich hätte gern gewusst, was Arbogast in dieser Nacht für uns bereitgehalten hätte, wie wir das noch anders hätten lösen können. Aber ja, war ein erstes Experiment. Wie gesagt, das Abenteuer ist leider noch nicht auf Deutsch erhältlich. Ich hoffe, es kommt mal, denn ich finde es echt gut. Echt spannend und auch echt cool für komplett neue Spieler, die sich das mal ansehen wollen, weil es einem auch ein bisschen in die Regeln einführt. Ja, hinterlasst mir wie immer gern Kommentare, wie ihr es gefunden habt. Lasst mir ein Like da, gebt mir einen Daumen hoch und schreibt mir gern, ob wir solche englische Abenteuer auch in Zukunft machen können. Das war jetzt mal ein Versuch. Es gibt ja zum Beispiel noch Alone in the Forest, ist auch erst sehr kurz herausgekommen. Das ist wieder eine größere Sache, wo man, glaube ich, eine ganze Expedition zur Verfügung hat. Klingt aber sehr, sehr interessant. Würde ich ganz gerne mal machen. Daher lasst mich bitte wissen, ob ihr das sehen wollt. In diesem Sinne, danke, dass ihr mit dabei wart und bis bald.